Vietnam and how it came to be. Occupation of Vietnam, besides being taken often and barely forming its own nation from time to time, there are three major nations that held the region, one of which is in my job to talk about. First, the Ming and other Chinese occupations. Topic 1, the Chinese would take the region of Vietnam during its Chinese Empire, but the biggest occupation that shaped Vietnam would be the Ming, which would attempt to make the Vietnamese people more Chinese, and this would be taught through language and history through schools they would establish. There is also the short-lived Japanese occupation, which would establish the short-lived Vietnamese Empire, a puppet of Japan. Life in rural Vietnam, living during rural Vietnam, you're most likely living in a village or hamlet. Most people would stay in a village or hamlet for most of their lives. The jobs are often being a farmer or not much else. If you're lucky, you might be a shop owner. Mostly, though, you would be a farmer or have a slight administrative job. Side info, most of the times, family would be given small amount of land, but they were taxed heavily, of course. Life in urban Vietnam. If you live in urban Vietnam, congratulations, you're getting paid worse than the McDonald's employee. The jobs, you can become a factory worker where you're not getting paid enough and ship off cheap products to most likely the United States. Of course, there would be shop owners and other small businesses and administrative work. Since exporting stuff is a major thing, you could also be a port worker. Many cities would get affected during work, taking a toll on the already weak and economic situation. The Viet Cong, in a brief history, the Viet Cong would be the main opposing force to the US in the South. The Viet Cong would often hide in civilian areas, which would help their cause by hurting the opinion between the civilians and the United States and South Vietnamese. A brief history on the Viet Cong. They were originally formed as a fight for freedom from Ho Chi Minh of the Vietnamese independence group. They lost their fight in their early 50s, but lived on through Ho Chi Minh and the National Liberation Front, which was a group made up of many different ideologies. Living in the tunnels, the Viet Cong would use these tunnels to surprise enemy forces and take the shock advantage. But how was living in the tunnels like? The tunnels were tight and either had a crouch or a crawl around, but they had many facilities in them, like water, food, medical, and these, and most of course, guns. These tunnels were not small things either. They were roughly 4 miles long at their peak. These tunnels could also